One of the biggest challenges facing Nevada's growing produce industry is making sure we're doing all we can to keep the food supply safe and reliable. We decided to make this film to take an in-depth look at how Nevada growers and distributors are managing this challenge.
The Desert Farming Initiative is a demonstration, research, outreach, and educational farming program at the Nevada Agricultural Experiment Station. We're a unique program because we're a small commercial farm, and we focus on producing a whole variety of vegetable crops and fruits, and we even have a 2-acre vineyard. The DFI farm is a demonstration farm for the state of Nevada for on-farm food safety practices. We've been contracted out by the Nevada Department of Agriculture to provide technical assistance to other farmers in the state to produce food safety farm plans, and also just to be a general resource for them. We also can provide them on-the-ground technical assistance if they have any questions about certain practices, or if they're unsure about how to implement a food safety practice. That's what we're here for. We're also here for the research aspect as well. So in the long term, we'll be looking at bringing research onto the farm that helps enhance the understanding of food safety when it comes down to the scientific understanding of, say, microbial issues or foodborne pathogens. Out of the whole economy of Nevada, the agricultural and food economy constitutes $1.3 billion. And of that, vegetables and other fruits like melons are roughly about $2.3 million of value to the state. We do have a growing agricultural economy here, especially for small farms, and so it's becoming even more important that an organization like the Desert Farming Initiative is here to serve this growing farming community and to help them understand their food safety regulations and food safety practices.
The pathogens that we're looking for are bacteria, such as E. coli or Salmonella, or viruses and parasites that get on fresh produce. And what we're trying to prevent is that happening on our farm and farms across Nevada. It's complicated to figure out exactly how pathogens are coming into contact with our food, from where the produce starts on the farm to the dinner table. We do know that there's a lot we can do to reduce the risk of that happening, though. The produce safety rule has farmers look at ways to reduce those risks, including looking at the water we use on the farm. If we're using soil amendments, what are they, and do they come in contact with our produce? How are we managing animals on the farm? And worker health and hygiene, among other things. The Desert Farming Initiative is helping growers across the state develop food safety plans, including those elements. Laying out procedures for handling and washing produce helps us track the safety and quality of our crops. A good example of this is how we treat the water we use for rinsing produce in our triple bin sink. Treating the water prevents cross-contamination or the spread of contaminants through the wash process. Chemical safety information, labeled measuring equipment, and a clipboard right at hand for record keeping help us track produce safety.
My name is Rick Latin. I'm the owner of Latin Farms. And the hearts of gold cantaloupe have been grown in this valley for over 100 years. They're an heirloom well known in the area. And we grow tomatoes and a lot of other things too. Produce safety is very important to our farm. Most of our customers are within 150 miles of our farm, and they're regular customers that have done business with us for years. And they expect a quality product, and the only way we can guarantee that is to have a good food safety plan on the farm. I think in terms of produce safety, it's probably the changing of the regulations and learning what we need to do. We've sent people to the produce safety classes. And a lot of this is not new to us in the sense of most of it is common sense, but I think the hardest thing about the food safety is in the day-to-day implementation of the program. It's especially challenging for some of the items that are in the newspaper all the time with recalls and sick people and the challenge of figuring out just the best way to keep from having a product that's contaminated. And melons are a great example because they're very much a challenge to keep them clean. But we think we've set up the best system we can, given we're dealing with small amounts of locally produced products. I think the number one prevention of contamination is training, and we're not doing enough of it or often enough, but training of our staff, because that's where the problem starts, is out in the field and in the hoop houses. So we're a bear on washing hands and not taking items into the field and cleaning out the pickups and the wagons they use. I think that's the challenge. It's not the long-range things, it's the day-to-day things that are a challenge. Have you washed your utensils? Have you sterilized the knives you're using? We also have a challenge in that our product is all over. We've got different fields all over the farm, and we don't carry porta potties around. So we've had to make sure that our employees know about taking breaks on a regular basis. And I think it's a challenge for small farmers because we really aren't set up with a lot of staff that's their full-time job. And things that we can do that seem to make sense if you're doing 10,000 pounds don't make sense when you're doing 1,000 pounds. And so that's something that's challenging. On the other hand, it's an advantage in that perhaps you can put eyes on stuff a little more carefully and not have something sneak out a way that has problems.
So my name is Zach Kennedy. The farm's name is Prema Farm. We're a 1.5-acre certified organic no-till farm. When we started, you know, like you're coming up against the infrastructure cost of sanitization and to running things on a scale that's competitive with huge farms. And so, you know, when we started, we grew mostly bunched greens and cooking greens, which we didn't know at the time, but those are actually some of the highest risk incidences as far as food safety goes. You have like a lot of animal products that have huge outbreaks, but as far as individual instances go, leafy green exposure is the largest pathogen carrying substance out there. And so when you don't know that stuff and you're kind of coming out, you're harvesting bunch kale and you're just trying your best to wash it, there's no real idea what the sanitization process actually looks like. And I think that when you ask that stuff, or when you're a farmer, you're wondering like, hey, what should I be doing? And that kind of level of infrastructure and information isn't something that's just readily available or a handout to most people. And it may even fall towards the bottom of your list as a new producer as well. And so what we rub up against is trying to invest in the level of infrastructure and the time as a farmer to put aside to develop all of the systems to make sure that you're GAP compliant or FSMA compliant, and which may not necessarily be reasonable on a small scale farm because you're so tied up and so consumed just in production that you think about developing systems and all of these other things that are going to make you compliant. It feels like it's overwhelming and unreasonable, but it's actually not, but it feels like that. There's a ton of risk, you know, when you're, if you don't know the quality of the water and you jump into something like this and you're trying to feed people, you have a lot of folks out there that may potentially be immune compromised, elderly folks, young children that are really like searching for your produce. And when you're feeding people that, you know, like food that hasn't been adulterated in any way or processed in any way, that's just raw produce, there's a strong likelihood that it could be carrying a potential pathogen. And so if you're giving that to somebody, it's one of the worst things that I feel like personally that you could ever do to somebody is to make them sick by something that you grow just because, you know, you haven't paid enough attention to what you're doing or you're not up to date on what's being asked of you as a farmer.
I'm Sarah Brinkley. I work with Perry & Sons and Nevada Fresh Pack. I'm the Director of Organics and Food Safety. With Nevada Fresh Pack and Perry & Sons Farm employing the majority of the ag workforce in the state of Nevada, we find it very important to educate our employees to prevent anybody from ever getting sick. With our large H2A workforce, we have an orientation team that provides all the trainings. These trainings I then provide to the orientation team. This will cover everything from the facilities to the fields, just in general, a good broad food safety program. And then once they get into their specific departments or facilities, then I'm able to narrow down closer as to what their risks are going to be. The field workers will receive GAP, good agricultural practice training, to help them prevent contaminating the product at the field level. This will be from marking off if they see animal intrusions, flooding, related to the field specifically. With the produce safety rule and the requirements of water testing, we're fortunate enough to use well water for the majority of our product. Still with that, we do test. We do a rolling mean to begin with, and then we test monthly while using our product.
I'm Ashley Debson. I work with the Nevada Department of Agriculture and I oversee our produce safety education and enforcement program. It's hard to come up with regulations that fit every sized farm or every scope of farm, so the rules are really geared at identifying the needs of a farm. So there can be some variability on what those specific needs are. So it's really identifying risks on your farm and coming up with measures to prevent those. The biggest thing to emphasize is, you know, sometimes we get questions about whether these rules are really needed, and we're still seeing outbreaks, so are these rules effective? I think something to understand with these regulations is we're continuing to learn from outbreaks. There are still outbreaks happening that have happened over the last couple years, and fairly significant outbreaks, but we're learning from how those outbreaks took place to what we can do to prevent them in the future. And we're continuing to learn from the science and giving growers tools to help them to progress and not have those incidents happen moving forward. So we can continue to look at outbreaks and glean that information and apply it in our state to have a stronger food safety program. Something that was really important for the Nevada Department of Agriculture is we wanted to partner with an agency that can serve as an example. And Desert Farming Initiative, being a research farm, they're actively engaged in production. They can speak to the challenges that growers sometimes experience. So they're actively in the field, they're dealing with those same challenges, and they can provide recommendation to growers on what some of those challenges look like.
My name is Nicole Salivary. I'm the coordinator of DROPP. DROPP stands for Distributors of Regional and Organic Produce and Products. We're a department of the Great Basin Community Food Co-op. I've been the one at our store that is constantly reminding people to wash their hands. I think that it's really important that we're good stewards of the food that we bring in from the local farms, so that we take good care of it while it's there, not only for the food safety issue, but the quality of it, so that we can pass that on to the member owners and customers of our grocery store and the restaurants so that it's of value to them and that we do it in a safe manner so that we're not, one, putting the farm at risk, or two, putting any of our customers or the co-op in general at risk. Another thing that's really important is that we know where our food is coming from and that we really have a good relationship with our suppliers. That's been a really big part of our whole process as we've developed relationships with our local growers and local producers over the years, is we have a set of applications. Depending on what the producer is selling to us, we ask different questions, but we want to know, you know, where our food is coming from, who the people are that we're working with, what kind of land they have, where they get their seeds, how they treat their workers, how they train their workers. We like to know as much as we can about the farm and have a good relationship with that farm. And then we also make visits out to the farms as well so that we can see it and know where our food is coming from and share that information with the members of our store. I took the preventive controls qualified individual training this past January, and it's quite overwhelming. There's a lot of information, there's a lot of resources, there's a lot of links, there's a lot of different bacteria and viruses that can live at different temperatures, and it's just a bit overwhelming. And since we started working with Desert Farming Initiative and Jill on making the simplified food safety questionnaire template that we can give to our growers, that if they just fill in the blanks, they at least are aware of the produce safety rule, even if they're exempt from it. And they first even know if they're exempt or not, because there's a decision tree so that you can go through the steps and easily figure out if you're exempt or not. But then they can go through the questionnaire and know the six basic parts of the produce safety rule and know that they're aware of it, and also be able to just answer it and put in You know, this is how we clean our tools. This is how we train our employees. So the challenge has been taking that big set of information and trying to convey it to producers or even be on the same page with the producers and understand what it is. So working with Desert Farming Initiative on this has been extremely helpful and has simplified the process.
Thank you. All right, grab these guys right up over here.
Food safety is huge. So one of the things that I tell my cooks on a daily basis, one of our topics of conversation, not only with my cooks, but with my front of house staff, is that one of the reasons why I believe that we're one of the best restaurants in Reno is because we take pride and integrity in our food. So when you have integrity in your food, it's not just the ingredients saying, yes, I purchased the best ingredients. At the same time, it's saying that I know how to handle my ingredients. One of the training methods that I have that I practice with my prep cooks is before they become a line cook, before they're allowed to, they need to become, they need to go through the prep cook stages. And in those prep cook stages, teach them how to take care of product, how to properly wash product, how to properly store the product. Having a respect for the ingredients is first and foremost what you need to take into account when you're talking about food safety. If you don't know how to take care of your ingredients, then you don't, in my opinion, you really do not know a lot about food safety at all. Taking care of the product in the restaurant starts at the farms. In order for me to get good ingredients that have been taken care of properly, it's up to the growers and up to the farmers to make sure that the hygiene standards are being kept and practiced, not only while they're picking the ingredients, but also while they're farming the ingredients. You know, something as little as a drop of blood or some animal waste being blown across the wind from other farms really needs to be taken seriously, because when you have that kind of matter cross-contaminating with the food, you have people that go to the grocery store and are not expecting, or they go to the farmer's market and maybe they don't wash the carrot or the cucumber. They don't understand what goes into farming and all of the precautions, necessary precautions and steps that are taken into ensuring that we have a really great product to serve the people. It's not gonna get them sick at all.
We're really excited about the opportunity to continue grow as a commercial farm at the Agricultural Experiment Station here in Nevada. We find that to be a pretty unique situation for a program. And we really look forward to enhancing our ability to do on-farm food safety practices and bring more demonstration to the state of Nevada.
I've realized that Nevada growers, agencies, distributors of fresh food, and the university are really taking steps to make sure that our food supply is safe. One of the other things I've learned is that we're still learning a lot about produce safety, both how pathogens come into contact with food and how we can reduce those risks. And as we learn more about food safety, DFI will be an ongoing resource for growers across the state.